Third time's a charm, but for only one team. Nick and I'll find out which team continues on their quest for a championship after today's third-round game between the Texas A&M Aggies and the Davidson Wildcats.
Hey, Brad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all of those other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
The Wildcats should be looking at a tough fight tonight, Dick. What have they got to do to win this thing?
They've got to stick to their game plan and focus on these keys. First of all, don't allow any good looks from beyond the arc. Challenge every shot. Second, take care of the basketball. Turnovers can really kill any rhythm offensively. Lastly, play every defensive possession like it's the last.
Well, Dick, let's get down to the court and let's get the action underway. The Aggies will step to the line for the first time. Makes the first. Second one is no good.
Try to go inside.
Ferguson handles the feed. Fakes a jumper for the bucket. They still don't score. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Dumps it in. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
There's the pick. There's the roll. Receives the pass. Off the rim and no good. Curran receives the ball. Looking for a good shot. They look to get it to the inside. Tries for two. The Wildcats have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
This is just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I'll tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
Keeps the dribble as they regroup.
Oh, what a strip, Red.
Goes up for two. He makes the shot. Ferguson is feeling great out there right now.
Yeah, no kidding, partner. When you have some success, you start to gain some confidence.
From beyond the arc, he gets the shot to fall. Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
Well, thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. Texas A&M are showing signs of a good run here, Dick.
They look like they've put it together for a moment. Hey, let's see how long they can keep it up.
The skip pass is picked off. He takes the shot from the baseline. Way off target. Trying to feed inside. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
The point guard handles the pass.
Shooter spotting up on a three.
Jarrett fakes the shot.
Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Tries to turn and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
They say forget about it, and then he does a little dribbling out here and turns it over.
Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Great anticipation.
That's great court savvy to get in the way of that pass.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Got to control yourself. This crowd is unbelievable tonight.
Oh, they're emotional. They're packed. They're jammed. You can't find an empty seat.
To the line. He He makes the first.
That's an 8-0 run.
And he doesn't miss that opportunity either.
That's 9 unanswered. Nice fake.
He squares up down in the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up and get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
Pass in the paint. The ball goes out of play. Dick, here we are by midway in the first half. Good ball game. Both teams look like they have a chance to win this thing.
I tell you, two teams well coached, two teams who understand about offensive and defensive efficiency and understand to minimize fast break opportunities. This game is coming down to who can execute better in their half-court game, because you're not going to get any easy layups tonight.
Loads a three. Texas A&M are on a nice little run at the moment, partner.
They have to remember solid defense leads to good offense, which is what we're seeing right now.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Palmer steps to the line for the first time. First one, good. And he got them both. Gave it up. Jumps into the defender. Basket falls despite the contact. The outside jumps in, up and in. Turns it over. Time to pick up the defense here now. Pump fakes, kicks it out. There's a high screen. Top of the circle. The Wildcats have got to continue to get him the ball.
Brad, he's on fire.
Tries the turn. The defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
For two.
I tell you, great job protecting the basketball, getting deep post position, and the jump hook is so effective.
Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help side.
They'll work it around the arc.
He missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle. Was locking out of the box.
Off the rim and no good. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
From downtown. The Wildcats have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Looking for a good shot.
Got to take some pride on a defensive end.
comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset for the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
They work it around the perimeter. He shoots from outside. The Wildcats have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Daddy's on fire.
Dick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
This may be a good opportunity for them, Brad.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
That's good. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again.
Nice high post screen.
Leans in.
The layup.
They're far from settled on defense.
Hey, the rotation needs to tune up, Brad. And they better do it quickly.
With the catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I tell you, great spin move to the basket.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, guys, the battle in the paint has played a major factor in this game and is probably some of the reason why they have this lead. If things don't change in a hurry, this game could get ugly, guys.
And I think she's right about that, Richie.
I'll tell you one thing. You better be able to establish post play because that gives you inside-outside action. Look at this, Mr. Nestler. He has a little something for the opposition. That, to me, is a no-no.
Number 23 comes in for his first go-around tonight, Dick.
I'll tell you, the offense doesn't miss a beat when this guy comes in.
He makes it.
It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
Oh, and the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
Working it around the perimeter. He shoots from the baseline.
Nice job of dribbling off the screen. But the shot just didn't fall.
There's a bad pass right to the defender. With the catch, nice execution on the spin.
I tell you, great spin move to the basket.
With the bomb. No. At the half, the Aggies lead by 11. This one's been a nail-biter so far, Dick. What play do you think set the tone in the first half, in your opinion?
In my opinion, Mr. Nestler, this trifecta is what set the tone for the offense in the first half. It represents the deep arsenal of threats this team has to offer.
Well, Dick, let's see what's in store for us here in the second half. Davidson has allowed a lot more turnovers than I'm used to seeing them have in a first half, Dick.
I must admit it, I'm still trying to figure out their game plan. Do they think they can win without any offensive possessions? It would take a miracle for that to happen.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Erin Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment, guys.
Thanks, Erin. Dick, he's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
For two, perfectly executed.
Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
with that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He draws a foul. And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
Out there, Brad, you always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their team's quality shots, good opportunities? The team which takes care of these things usually is in a better position to win a game.
Got them both.
He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. You're 15 to 17 feet apart.
He's got the post flashing if he wants it. The crowd really admires this young man.
The fans know exactly how much he has done for this program. Look at that. That's unbelievable, baby.
They work it around the perimeter. The Aggies have a mismatch in the post.
They need to get him the ball there.
The Aggies are ahead by 13. From three-point land, way off target. Gets it back out. He tries to knock down the three. Dick, they really need to get something going in a hurry here.
Yeah, call a timeout and get your boys into the game, Brad.
And a momentary look from three-point land. From right at the circle. Off the rim and no good. The center with the ball. Good fake. He up fakes. Tries for two. Off target. Work it around the arc. With the fake.
High post screen. So effective, that screen.
Tries for two. And in and out. Going to move it around the perimeter.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Off the rim and no good.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Working around the perimeter. Looking for contact. He puts it in with contact and all. On the dribble, gives it up. Bland, pounded on his way up. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, it's a silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
At the free throw line. Opportunity. He hits the first shot. Second shot is good. No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones. Look at that spacing.
Sampson's modest play is having a negative effect on his composure. Emotionally, he couldn't be much lower, I don't think.
Emotionally, he needs some inspiration.
And the ball goes out of play. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, a sense of urgency down here on the bench. The coaching staff is starting to sense their players are starting to panic, and they want that stopped before any further damage is done. Guys?
Nice fake.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Gave it up. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
The shot won't fall. Spin move not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Rims out.
They've got a shooter spotting up on the three-point line.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man. I sometimes wonder what it would be like to be a Skywalker. Elevating and throwing it down, Mr. Nestler. How much fun would that be?
Trying to draw some contact, and he scores despite the hack. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Goes up for two.
I tell you, once you get deep position like that, it's automatic.
There's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Top of the circle. And he misses the shot. In the paint. There was no doubt about that one. The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal him off.
High post screen.
Holt draws the personal. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Number 45 walks out to get his first minutes tonight.
They have such a deep bench, Brad. This kid could start for any program in the land.
Except this one, apparently.
Well, you never know what the story really is.
Makes the foul shot. They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
On the dribble, gives it up. Takes away the pass. For two, and he missed. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Doesn't go. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Looking for a good shot. He takes the shot off the baseline. Off the rim and no good. Gave it up. Fakes the shot. Controlling the ball. And the ball goes out of bounds. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups. Inside.
On the dribble, gives it up. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad.
Play to take that to the basket.
Looking to move it around the perimeter.
I think right now, got to focus defensively.
From downtown, he drains it. power forward gets the pass.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Gave it up. Got a wide open look. He puts it up quick to beat the clock. He drained the trifecta. He intercepts it. Looking for a good shot.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Number 34 with the fake. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
The point guard gets the ball. Looking for a screen on top and got it. With the big shot.
Nick, sometimes statistics lie, but in this tournament game, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going on.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Rab, and you look at it and analyze it because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
Dick, let's check out that State Farm drive of the game.
Hey, what a great move, Brad. He was able to find an opening and finish at the basket. That's a great finish. Highlight material, baby.
The Aggies makes it three in a row with an impressive third-round victory.
Hey, the way they're playing, Brad, this team is going to be hard to deal with entering the Elite Eight.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.